Hello and welcome to Sheva online classes, standard 8. Today I'll be taking grammar. That is, what is the topic of our grammar is question tag. Okay, now question tag, it is there in the page number 192. Okay, so page number 192, please refer the page number 192. Okay, so everything is there, but if you see it, you won't understand. You need explanation before you write the exercise. Okay, now what is the question tag? First thing is, what's the definition of question tag is? It's a short questions at the end of the statement. Okay, now one statement, a short question. Now you don't have to ask what is your name, not like that. Okay, so one sentence, and end of the sentence there is one small tag. Aren't you? Isn't it? Don't you? Won't you? Have you heard this? Isn't it? So isn't it? See, now the way I am saying is, isn't it? So all these are known as question tags. Okay, end of the statement you will have this question tag. So the statement that is short questions at the end of the statement, that is the definition. In question tag there are two different, that is it's divided into two. What is it? One is positive statements, that is positive statements is followed by a negative tag. Positive statements will be followed by a negative tag, and then another one is negative statement. See, the negative statement will be followed by a positive question tag. Okay, now just given you the, that is a flow chart given here. What is the tag? And then I've given how tags are, question tag divided into two, positive and negative. So positive sentence will have a negative tag, negative sentence will have a positive question tag. So till here you understood? Okay, now you want to know how is it formed, how are these tags formed? Okay, what is the thing, what two words are made to make a tag? So what is it? Now it is actually auxiliary or model plus that not, see the how is the not, N-O-T not, no, not that O is missing. So instead of that O, you put that apostrophe, okay? So that not, you're not going to put the full not, N-O-T you're not going to write. You're just, that is, you're making a contracted form. So completely, this is a contracted form of writing, this question tags. Not and plus the pronoun. It, he, she, is, he, she, they, ours, other kind of, so all the pronouns, okay? So this is usually in a contracted form. What's a contracted form? This only is known as contract form. See that? All this is a contracted form. So this, what is the full form of would, wouldn't? Wouldn't is the word. Wouldn't means would plus not is would not. Okay? And then can't. What is can't? Can't means we that is shortened form. Contracted form of cannot is can't. That is N, that O is apostrophe. Okay? Then wasn't. Was and not together is known as wasn't. And here see, isn't. Isn't means is and not together, isn't. And then don't, do and not, don't, do not is don't. And won't is will plus not is will not. Together we say it in a tag, we say it is won't. Okay, got that now? These are the, in your page number 193, there are all the words are given to you. You just go through it. Just have given you how to, I'm just explained to you what is the contracted form. How do we use these things? How are they formed, right? And now I'll tell you how to write the positive sentence. I told it question tag divided into two, no? That is what? Positive statement will take up the negative tag. You know how to write the tag, isn't it? Now see there. Now what do I mean by positive statement? The positive statement means a statement which does not have a negative statement. That is not, no, never. These kind of words are not given. Okay, if those words are not there, mean that is a positive statement. Okay, so when the no, not, never is not here in this sentence means, then you must use that here. You must show it here. Okay, so that's what I'm telling you. Positive statement will take up the negative tag. What is the meaning of negative? I told you negative means all. No, not, never, none, all these kind of words are negative words. So those negative words must be, are not there in the statement segment. So you must use it in the tag. So isn't, I told you what, what's the full form of isn't? Isn't full form is what? Is not, isn't it? So this is the negative. Not is the negative, isn't it? So that negative tag must be here, isn't it? So that is not, you contracted form, contracted and say right there. It is isn't she. So I told you, no, modal, that is auxiliary verb, plus what I told you, plus the not, that is contracted not, plus the pronoun. So here the pronoun is here, so the she must be here. So as another one clue I'll give you, how to present the, that's how you're going to write the tag. Now the she is given here, she is a doctor. Okay, that she is, when I write the tag, no, this should come this side. Like, should go like that. Just vice versa. You don't just have to reverse the thing. This she is will become is she. And what you have to add is, I told negative no. So negative means not. You must add the not. So isn't she? That is the answer. Got that now? So whenever you see a positive statement, that means positive statement means what? Where there is no, not, no, never is not there means, then that kind of a sentence you have to use with a tag which has got a negative. Negative means what? No, not, never. So what is isn't is not. So got it now? Not is there, no? So that's a negative. Negative tag. So isn't she. How to write that? I told you. Now the first part is she is given to you. That she must come, the is must come this side, she must go this side, and you have to add the not. That's all. Simple. Okay, now next one. We should obey our elders. Now who was this? We means we. So again, see the vice versa. Just turn it. You bridge this side like that. And what is the sentence? It's a positive sentence. Do you see any no, not, never you were here? No, no. So what is it? It is a positive statement. We should obey our elders is a positive statement. And the positive statement will take up what kind of a tag? That is negative tag. That is, what's the meaning of shouldn't? Should not. Isn't it? Should and not. Should not, what you're doing is, you are bringing it to a contracted form. That is shouldn't. We're taking off the O, that's all. Shouldn't we? I told you before itself, the we must come this side. Just interchange. Interchange the thing. That is the pronoun. So, we should obey our elders. Shouldn't we? Question mark. The question mark is very, very important. Okay, write the question mark. If you don't write the question mark, you will not be getting 1/2 mark. Okay. So, that's very important because it's a question tag. A small form of question. So, that question tag must always have a question mark. That punctuation marks is necessary. Okay. Okay, next one is the that is the apostrophe when you're putting, no, please put the apostrophe correctly on the place where the O is not there. Don't put it here. Sometimes children, what they do is, in a hurry, you just put it somewhere here. That is wrong. Okay, wherever that N is, that see N-O-T, no, N-O-T, that O is not there. Instead of that, only you're putting the apostrophe. Okay, so accordingly, you must put the tag properly. Okay, next one. Now, say, I just understood this. Now, next one is, negative statement gives you a positive tag. Okay, takes up a positive tag. And same thing, just like vice versa. Now see, the negative statement means what? What is negative? I told you, always remember, negative means this no, not, never, none. These are the negative words. Negative words. Okay, negative words, if they are used in a sentence, means it is a negative statement. Okay, so we don't have enough time. So don't, what is the don't? What's the full form of don't? Do not. So there's a not over here, no? So it's a negative statement. So we don't have enough time. Now we are having, see, a negative statement, that is not is there in the statement itself. If the not is there in the statement, then what kind of a tag do we take up? A positive tag. So that the not should not be used over here, because two negative cannot be in one statement. Okay, so now negative sentence, we take up a positive tag. So answer is do we. Now same thing, same procedure only I told you, no? Interchange. This do, not you are going to take off the not you must take it off. And do we, that's a question mark. Got that now? That is it. Next one, next example. Children shouldn't watch TV too much. Children shouldn't watch TV. What is shouldn't? Should I told you before itself? Should and not together. Should and not together is only shouldn't. Shouldn't. See that? So it's a negative statement. Okay. So negative statement, because not is there. So what kind of a tag it will take up? It will take up the positive tag. Now same thing again. See here. This part what you're doing is, children means what? We can't say shouldn't children. It is they. There, that is, it's a plural. Children is a plural. So child means one person. So children is plural. So take it as plural means what? It will change to they. Okay. So now this just interchange this. Should they. Got that now? Should they. So answer is, children shouldn't watch TV too much. Should they? Question mark. So that question mark at the end of the tag is very, very necessary. Okay, you must do it, right? Now in question tags, there are some special cases. Okay, so see your page number 195. All the words are given to you. 194 and 195. All the words are given to you. Just see the statements using barely, hardly, rarely, scarcely, neither, no, nobody, none, nothing, and seldom are treated as negative statement. So these kind of some words are written on the board. See, these words are taken as negative words. In a statement, if there are negative words like this, that is also negative. I told you before, no? Only no, not, never. So this is no, not, no, this kind of never. These words are negative words. Okay? These are open negative. You can see the open, that is definitely we can say, ah, this is negative, isn't it? But some words, these are also negative words only. Okay, so you have to better just learn it up, okay, just by heart these words, okay. So you can say, you should not take this as a positive statement, this also is negative. What's the meaning of hardly? First you must know the meaning of it, okay. So only then you can understand if it is in the statement means, then you'll say, oh, this is a negative statement. So if it's a negative statement, what kind of a tag must put? Positive tag. So that automatically you should come. So for that, no, you need to know the meaning. Hardly, what's the meaning of hardly is never. He hardly comes to school. That means he never comes to school. That means next is rarely. Rarely means once in a way. Very rarely I come to, does his homework. That means he hardly never does his homework. That means is equal to never. Okay. And then seldom also same thing. That is meaning. Nothing, of course, no, nothing. There you can see the thing, nothing. Nothing is there in the bottle. There is no water in the bottle. Nothing is there. Nothing means nothing is there. Nothing means no. Is equal to no. Okay, so these kind of words are also are negative words. All right, so negative words will take up the positive tag. Okay, right now see here, see the example I've written on the board. He hardly works. Now some people will say, wow, he hardly works means he's doing a lot of work. No, that is wrong. It is here, it is a negative word, negative word. This is meaning of hardly is never. Okay, get that down. Meaning of hardly, meaning is never. Okay, so always hardly. Some people have it wrongly said, they use it very in a wrong way. Hardly is not doing lot of hard work. Hardly means never. The meaning of it is never. Okay, he hardly works. So what kind of a statement that is? Does he? Now you will be asking me. I told you earlier. You just have to interchange the pronoun and the word. Now here that word is not given. No, how will you write it? So you must try to understand that. See the. He hardly works. Now just keep this, cover this part and say, he hardly works. How does he work? What kind of a question you ask? How does he work? He hardly works. So does is the word, do. Okay, do, does. Okay, that is present tense, does. Okay, he hardly works. Works is a present tense here. So only I am putting does. How does he work? How does he work? One question you ask means that does itself you can get the word for you to present the tag. Okay. So how does he work? He hardly works. Does he? Okay, that's a question tag. One small tag is given, does he? Now next one is they seldom speak. That means they never speak. Very rarely, very once in a thing they speak. Okay. So they seldom speak. Now what, how do they speak? What's the question you will ask? How do they speak? They seldom speak. That means very rarely, very less. They speak very less. So they seldom speak. So that kind of, what kind of a question you will be asking? How do they speak? So do is the word for you. Okay. That do you are going to add as a tag. And of course they. Okay. Got that now? The pronoun is they. So this is also another special cases. So these words you must know to make it a negative sentence. A positive tag, right? So we hope you understood this, how to write the question tags. There are exception, that is 195, page number 195. There are a few exceptions. There's let means we have to use shall be. Then affirmative imperative is there. That is that kind of affirmative imperative words means you have to use will you, won't you, and then everybody, anybody, and that kind of words, aren't they, that is those kind of tags you must use. Yeah, negative imperative is there. That kind of words you have to use will you. That is negative imperative means what? That is if there is a negative word in the statement and it is an imperative. That means it is you are asking kind of order. That kind of a statement will always take up will you only. And so these are some words given there. You just go through it. And then the exercise is given page 195 and 196. So hope you do the homework whatever is given to you. Right after the video, refer, that is you don't have to do it everything without looking. You see the video and then you go through the full book. Now you will understand the book exercise, that is whatever the explanation is given to you. Now it will easily you will understand, because once I have explained it to you, it will be easy for you. So read that page 192 to 195, the complete explanation is given. So once you read it and then answer the go to the exercise and answer the questions, right? Okay, now next I'm going to take is page number. Next is what? Verb, forms of verb. So forms of verb, it is the last page. Go see that, that is page number 224. Okay, page number 224, you will get these words. Page number 224. Okay, forms of verbs. Now verbs, what are the parts of speech you learned already? Parts of speech are what? Nouns, verbs, adjectives and adverbs, right? So these are the parts of speech. There are so many others also, but major parts of speech are only these. Now we are going to study about the verbs. What are verbs actually? Verbs are action words, isn't it? Action word, action. Some words are not, some words, verbs, where you can't see action are what? Is, was, were, had, have. These are also verbs only, but where you cannot see the action. With that, there is something else is there, means is talking, is walking. Okay, that is what? A verb is given to you. Okay, so that is action words are known as verbs, which are words which are not, action is not seen. I told you the words. Okay, so here in the page number 224, we are going to see how a verb, we are going to change to past tense and then the past participle. Okay, what is that? Now for example, say begin is the word. Begin is a present tense, begin. Now same thing, begin, writing in the past tense is what? Began. Okay, began is the word. And then what's the past participle of is, that is begun. See, only the spellings have been changed. I-N-A-N-U-N, that's all. Begin, began, begun. Okay, so these are the words, some words, and there's a whole list of words given to you here. You please go through it. See here, bent, and then break, broke, broken. So some words, spelling will change. For example, see, grow is the word. And what is the past tense for grow is? Grew. And what is the past participle is? Grown. Okay, this is see the spelling, N we are adding, grown, right? So write, wrote, written. Blow, blew, blown, some words. So these are all the past participle, that is these are the that is some words are given, nearly so many, two to three pages of words are given to you. Please go through it, understand it and then write it. The exercises are not given to you, but you'll be asked the thing in your exams. So please go through it. You'll be given only the base word will be given to you. You have to write the past tense and the participle, right? Go through the grammar part, understand it. The method only is very important. If you know the method, doing grammar is very, very easy. So because some people don't like to, some children hate grammar. But once you know the method, no, it's very easy, right? You will start loving the thing, grammar part. Thank you. See you next class.